Hello YouTube. It's been a while since I've done a computer haul video. Was last one I did was back in May of 2014. It's been a while since I got like a bunch of crap, just all at once. This time, today I have April 20th. It's actually the 21st today, but I got all this yesterday, but I was a bit too tired after going to TAFE and going to work, to do a video. But anyways, yeah, I got them today. I got them yesterday, but doing a video today. What's in these bags? You may be wondering. Well, shit. Something fell down. You may be wondering what's in these bags. Now, I got all this stuff from my uncle. He was staying with us for a couple months after he used to live in Western Australia. He moved there in 2008. I think 2007 or 8, I don't remember exactly, but it's been a while. And he just came back to my state, which is Victoria, in Australia. A few months ago anyway. So he's found a place and he's living somewhere and he has, got a job and everything. Around Christmas time, around January, or a little bit after Christmas, he sold me his old PlayStation 2 there, which I may have mentioned before in a few videos, probably a room tour that I did, and maybe the one of the Xbox there. I mentioned I had a PS2. I got that from him back in January with a couple of controllers and a whole bunch of games. So a couple weeks ago, he sent me an email asking if I wanted to have some old computer stuff and some more PlayStation 2 equipment that he had in storage, in a storage thing. Apparently this storage thing hasn't been, apparently the storage unit, that's what I was looking for, the storage unit hasn't been touched in about 10 years, so a lot of this stuff is either from his old place of work or some of his own personal stuff that he may have bought. So he asked if I wanted it all because he wanted to clear out the place, and I said, sure, I'll take it, see what there is. So I didn't ask anything about it, so this was all a surprise to me yesterday. I knew that he had the stuff, but I knew he was going to give it to me, but I didn't know exactly why, I didn't know anything about it, so we're going to go through it. There's three computers, and then there's some PlayStation 2 stuff as well, so let's go through it all. So, in this bag, we'll start off with this bag here. There's a USB cable, random USB cable, who cares? Here is a booklet for a Nintendo 64 game, apparently. I don't even remember my uncle having a Nintendo 64. Bought it from Blockbuster Video. Yeah. They're still in business. Not. But it's a manual for an N64 game. I don't have the game, but it's a manual for something. It's covered up by the stickers, so I don't know what it is. I could read the manual, but I don't want to. There is a an original PlayStation demo CD with some interesting artwork. Definitely 90s, but let me just get the disc out. It's a PS1. Demo disc, there we are, one of the black discs, I don't know much about the original PlayStation stuff, but I guess all the discs were black, at least all the ones I have. I have a few games I got from my uncle, actually, some PS1 games, and of course these do work on the PS2, so I'm gonna have to see what's on this demo disc and try it out. My PS2 does read these black discs, so that's good. Here is the PlayStation 2's the Survival Guide. Basically, this is just an accessory book, a booklet full of what accessories you could have bought for the PlayStation 2. I think this dates from about late 2001 or early 2002, because there's a lot of games that say whatever 2002 says. Gran Turismo 3, I actually have that game. There's a PlayStation remote. The memory cards and multi-tap. You can see the vertical and horizontal stands. Logitech racing wheel, another controller, just a DualShock 2, more games, more games. I think this is the rest of this is games. Anyway, I'm not gonna go through them all, but you know, just if you want to read what they are, just pause the video. So yeah, that's it. So I have a few other little booklets like this for the PlayStation 2, so I guess I'll just put it with those. Here is a PC game. It's called Enemy, what is it? Enemy Engage 2. I looked this up, it dates from about 2007, so I don't know if it's any good. It's a some sort of flight simulator. Yeah, I don't know, I might put this on the XP rig and see how it is. So I see what it is. I don't know if it's a cheap, shitty game, a low-budget title, or if it's actually decent. Never heard of it before, so box is in shit condition, so I don't know, I might see what it is. I'll put it on the XP rig, play with it a bit. And here's the most interesting thing in this bag. This bag, anyway, not that one, but anyway, and that's this. This is a new-in-box PlayStation 2 network adapter. Very nice. So it comes with a game too. Hardware Online Arena. So yeah, it was an online game back then. Anyway, you can see a PS2 network adapter, and it is new in box. So it is sealed, the network adapter. So in the box here, we just have the game and the network adapter. So show you on the other side of the box here. So if you want to read all that, you can. Anyway, yeah, so, the game here is the game, so, Hardware Online Arena, I don't know, probably won't really, network play only, so I doubt this would work these days, because the network, even though the game, network, PS2, online titles were PS2 network, online titles were, you know, the developer controlled the online system, but I doubt this is up anymore. So anyway, so you can just see that. So I'll put that with my collection. It's got a good case, so I guess if I wanted to replace, I probably don't care about the game, but I guess if I need a new PS2, one of these blue cases, I guess I could use it for that. And here is something that the interesting part. This is a sealed, brand new, never opened PS2 network adapter. So it looks like it's got a disc in there too for it. So or something in there, network access something. So yeah, I don't know whether I should open this or leave it sealed, but yeah, new in box. So maybe I could do a retro unboxing, I suppose. But yeah, if you want to see that, let me know. Or if you want me to leave it sealed, also let me know. So yeah, what should I do with this? I kind of want to open it, but I kind of don't at the same time. So this has probably been sealed since about 2002, I reckon. So yeah. Anyway, so that's a brand new PS2 network adapter. So yeah. Anyway, and that's that. So let me just move all this out of the way. And now we get to some of the more interesting things. So this bag is heavy. I'll show you why it's so heavy. We have computers. First off, we have a docking station for a Toshiba, and I have the laptop this goes with, so yep, docking station for a Toshiba, and here is said Toshiba. Oh, it's heavy. This is a Toshiba. It's a Toshiba TE2100, so laptop, I think it's from very early 2000s. I'm not sure when it dates. We'll figure that out. So yeah, TE2100. So has a Pentium 4M, designed for Windows XP. So it's Windows XP era. So you can see, I think it's the TE, I think means Tekra, so it's part of their business line. It looks like a business grade laptop, and especially since it has a docking station, you know, it most likely is a business grade machine. So let's go around the machine. So here you can see is we only have the hard drive cat. Well, lack of hard drive caddy. That's a problem with this, and yeah, no hard drive and no hard drive caddy. So even though I can put a drive in there, it looks like it's a standard IDE drive. You can't really see that because of the light, the lack of light. But yeah, it takes a standard IDE hard drive, but no hard drive caddy. So I'm gonna have to order one of those if I want to use this. And I'm missing a power adapter for this, and yeah, the back, I have the power adapter. It looks like it's standard. I'll be able to get a generic adapter for it if I want to, but yeah. So here we have a serial port, parallel port. No, it's not serial, sorry, VGA, I'm retarded. VGA port, parallel, dial-up modem, Ethernet, RS-232 serial, two USB ports, and a PS2 port. So this is all behind the port door. Luckily, though, you don't have to access the port door very often unless if you're using Ethernet or a serial device or VGA. Luckily, the USB ports and the PS2 port can be accessed without this door being open, so that is a good... If you're going to have a door, do it like this. Just keep the actual ports you're going to use open to, like, yeah. On this side, we have a composite out, two PCMCIA card slots, and a DVD-ROM CD burner with a hardware volume wheel, and it looks like some sort of switch there as well. Not sure what that's for. Might be a Wi-Fi switch, or it might be a mute switch. But yes, hardware volume wheel, because Toshibas are like that. The optical drive, so DVD-ROM, CD rewriter combo drive. So some sort of switch here. Not sure what that's for actually. Lock and unlock. Maybe it's for the docking station. Didn't notice that before. Anyway, so on the bottom here we have it says Toshiba TE2100 model number. T10100 system unit. So, do we have like a date of manufacture on here or something? I have no idea. So, I can't read that through the camera. What's this? Yeah, something. I don't know. We have a code for Windows XP Professional. So, here's the battery. Let's just take the battery out. There's this little switch here, just do that and pull the battery out. You can see the battery. Let's see, we have like a date. Date code. No idea what that means. But J3034. So if anyone knows how to decode that date, then yeah, put that in the comments, I suppose, if you want to, or you don't have to, I guess. You can just, if you know how to decode it and you just don't want to give me the answer because you're a cunt, then yeah, I'll accept that, but anything goes around here. So one thing my battery pack, it's a 3600 milliamp hour battery. So yeah, anyways, here's the battery, here's the docking station connector. So yeah, unfortunately I cannot power this one up because I don't have a power adapter and I don't have a hard drive. Well, if I had a power adapter, I'd be able to power it up, but I don't have the hard drive caddy. I have a drive I could put in this, but I don't have a caddy for it, so I'm gonna have to get that as well as a power adapter and see how it is. So surprised there's no touchpad for how new this thing is. Oh, there's one thing I forgot. Yeah, you can actually take the CD-ROM out. This might tell me the date. So, hold on, let me just put the camera down here. You have to push this forward, and then pull out the drive. So, this might tell me a date, actually. I just remembered that. So, let's see. We have a DVD-ROM drive, model number. Let's see, where does it say? Manufacturer date. Date code J3034, so same one. Manufacturer date March 2003. Alright, okay, so this laptop's from about 2003. Okay, I kind of suspected it was from 2002 or 3 because of that Pentium 4 mobile. Anything newer than that, it probably would have been a Pentium M. But no, this is a Pentium 4 mobile. So yeah. Anyway, so gonna have to get that one running. Next laptop is a bit more interesting. That's this one. This is an Acer TravelMate. This is an Acer TravelMate 340T. So this is what's called a sub-notebook. Now, what a sub-notebook was is basically they were designed for business. Basically, they're the predecessor to what was known as the ultraportable or net. Oh, I don't want to say predecessors to netbooks. Netbooks were sort of their own thing, but these are sort of the predecessors to ultrabooks as we know them today. They were small, thin, and light laptops, premium, like small, premium, thin, and light laptops designed for business and designed for travel. So basically, in a typical laptop from about the time, this is not from about the time actually, that Dell up there is one of them anyway. So this would have been a big, expensive machine, probably. I don't know how expensive, but it would have been somewhat, you know. So something like this, if it was a Pentium 3 era, just like that. You know, you had your CD-ROM, some had floppies, and some had hard drives, some were tri-spindle. So instead of taking a big hulking brick like this around, you could take this. Now, you don't get a CD-ROM, you don't get a floppy, and yeah, so you don't get a CD-ROM, you don't get a floppy drive. However, you get really good battery life. Well, at least you would have brand new. I don't know if this one has any more, but it probably doesn't. Battery's probably dead. So looks like it's about a 12-inch or so screen. Decent sized keyboard, not. It's about s a little bit smaller than full size, however, I could still type on it, and I've got big hands, so touchpad with a left, right, and even a dedicated scroll button there, scroll rocker switch. So, yeah. Intel Pentium 3, so no idea how fast this one is. Anyway, so yeah. It's got a metal body to it, like it feels really cold to the touch, so which is nice. Metal lid. This thing looks like it'd take a bit of a beating. So you even have the old Acer logo there. Nice. So yeah. I'm not sure how old this one is. This one's probably maybe I'd say not Windows. So maybe the year 2000, maybe 1999, 2000, 2001. So on this side, we have Wi-Fi. No Wi-Fi. I guess these are Wi-Fi antenna areas here because this is a metal lid. I guess they needed some radio transparency, so maybe this does have built-in wireless. Here is that's where the battery is right there. We have a PCM CIA card slot, so with a blank. We have headphone, microphone, and line in. Where's the power switch? There's a power button, just a slider switch. Power adapter, a power cord, which unfortunately I don't have a power cord for this one either. USB, dial-up modem, 56K modem, probably 56K. Ethernet, infrared. Is that PS? Yeah, PS2. Sorry, I couldn't think of that. Parallel serial VGA and a vent. This side we have a Kensington lock. There's a looks like what's a docking station connector. It's got like a little metal thing here, so guess it's some sort of docking connector there. And here we have where the hard drive and hard drive caddy are supposed to go. Which unfortunately I don't have a hard drive or caddy for this one either. So and no power adapter. So yeah. Oh, and the front we have a latch. So other than that, this one I would really like to get going because it looks like a really nice machine. This would be a really good Windows 98 laptop, even though it doesn't have a built-in CD-ROM. It's still, if I could get like a parallel port CD-ROM, this would be a great Windows 98 laptop to travel with, just because it's so thin and light compared to, you know, if I was ever going to travel with a second computer around, because usually I travel with my T420. However, if I wanted to carry a retro computer with me around, it would have to be something like this, because I don't want to carry a big hulking brick with me. Speaking of big hulking bricks, The next laptop I have is exactly that, and it is by far the coolest out of all of them, at least in my opinion, because the older, the better. You ready to see what it is? Oh, that thing is heavy. Don't lift that with one arm. Actually, do. Maybe you could work out with it. This is a Toshiba Satellite Pro 430CDT. This thing is about as old as me. I was born in 1997, so, yeah, this thing is from about that time, actually. So, this is a Satellite Pro 430CDT. Here it is. Pentium. Yes, it is a Pentium-era laptop. Probably Windows 95. Anyway. So, this laptop is from about 1997, so I know someone who used to have one of these, but they sold it due to it not being not doing something. I think Billy Core might have had one. Yeah, he told me he had one when I posted about this. Yeah, he said he had one. Apparently, it doesn't panel stretch, but other than that, it's a good laptop for stuff. So, but goddamn, this thing is huge. So, look at the Travel Mate for comparison. You can see, yeah. And, just to even put it into perspective, here's a modern day 2015 smartphone, an Xperia Z5. So, you can see, look how far we've come in the last 19 years. So, yeah. Anyway, so, let's go around this laptop, Satellite Pro 430CDT. So, we have lots of latch there for the battery, so at least the battery cover anyway, so if I just push that down, cover comes off, and battery comes out. These use lithium ion batteries too, so if you wanted to get a replacement, you probably could. I haven't charged this one up yet, so, yeah, lithium-ion battery pack. 3600 milliamp hours. Oops, zooming in the wrong way. There we go. Just goes in like this. And the cover just goes on like that. So, there we are, we have a CD-ROM drive. Ugh. Big old brick. Whatever, looks like that would have been an infrared port there, but it's missing a cover, so, yeah, anyways, so we have VGA, parallel port, here's a docking station connector, we have a figure of eight, power connector, so this thing has a built-in power supply, so that means we can test this. All it requires is your standard, figure of eight cords that a printer would use, so, yeah. Definitely gonna power this one up in the video. So, we have a cooling fan there, and a PS2 port. This side, we have a serial port, and what looks like a proprietary port for something. Maybe it might be a modem or something, I don't know. Maybe it's another accessory you get for it, I don't know. If you guys know what that one is next to a serial port there, then, you know, let me know in the comments below. I'd like to find out what that is. So this is by far the most interesting of all the machines here, although that Acer I actually kind of want to get running too. I like the idea of that. That other Toshiba though, it's a pain in the four, so yeah. Another XP laptop, I already have like, you know, a few of them, so but anyways. Yeah, that Acer there I'd like to have running, but this one definitely is my favorite so far. Well, so far it's the only one. Anyways. Yeah, so PC, MCIA slots, so a power button, and we have a headphone and microphone, so, are they both headphone microphone? Yeah. Wait, one's, yeah, headphone microphone, sorry, I'm blind. Well, on the front here, we have a big old speaker, hardware volume level. Is that another headphone jack? Is that a line in? Speaker. Oh, there's two headphone outs. Okay. Well, that's a speaker out, but I guess you could plug in headphones and it's hardware volume wheel. So, this thing, I guess, would have been classed as a multimedia laptop because it has a sound card and an optical drive. So, anyway. So, opening it up. Not sure how big the screen is. Looks like it's about 12 inch or so. Let me open the Acer, because that's a 12 inch, so. The Acer's a bit bigger, actually, so maybe it's about a 10 inch. I don't know. Anyway, then we fell off the bed. Anyway, so, yeah, 430 CDT, Intel Pentium. So, not sure the speed of the Pentium, but, I don't think it's an it doesn't say MMX on there, so I guess it might not be, although it could be, I don't know. Keyboard, so, we have a little Eraserhead mouse, what's known as the track point, but it's not, because this is not an IBM, it's not a track point, so, nipple mouse, so it's grey, but, looks like it, I took this off earlier, looks like you can use a standard, ThinkPad one on there, so I could change that out if I wanted to. But this one's actually in really good shape, so it's still got a texture to it. So might not be able to see that on video, but it does. We have left and right click. So these buttons don't have much feedback to them. The keyboard, it's not mechanical, but it feels like it's a laptop keyboard. It's not a mechanical keyboard, but there's a lot more travel than I'm used to on a laptop. Maybe because it's so thick, they could do that. So this is by far the oldest computer I've ever owned. Before that, the oldest thing I've owned was a Pentium 2 something. So it was a Pentium 2 for about 98. So not that HP I had another machine when I was younger that was a Pentium 2. So this one's definitely the oldest machine I've ever had. I mean, actually I've actually had in my possession a 486 desktop, and I had a few 486s, but they never worked. So, I tried to get them working, but, they didn't. There were some white box 486 AT custom builds I had, probably about eight years ago. They were my dad's, but, he didn't give it, you know, they were my dad's. He got them in a whole junk pile of computer stuff, because he used to work on that stuff. He doesn't anymore, but, but I had some 486s and stuff. They never worked, though. But anyway, so this is by far the, oldest computer I currently own right now, so so this one we were able to power up, so I'll show you this docking. Oh, I forgot to show you the docking station as well for this Toshiba TE2100. So it's basically just a port replicator. It's not really a docking station, it's a port replicator, my bad. So we have some audio jacks, we have a couple USB ports, we have a 1394 FireWire power jack, PS2 keyboard and mouse, Ethernet, and dial-up modem. Sorry about that, I got interrupted. Dial-up modem, Ethernet pass-throughs. So, here we have a slider, it'll cover, goes from either VGA or DVI-I. So, you can tell it's not an analog, it doesn't work with any analog adapters, so, but anyway. Yeah, so VGA and DVI, so you can't use a second VGA adapter with this, and you couldn't use these two at once anyway, so it's one or the other, because of this little slider cover, so, we have parallel and serial, so, we have a big latch here to eject the computer, and, little Kensington lock over this side. This pulls out, so I guess if you had a smaller laptop with that same docking connector, you could use it, and then you just push that in, just like that. So anyway, that is everything I have gotten. So, overview. Got this PS2 sealed network adapter with the game there. A PC game that I might try it out. I don't know. I might just get rid of it. I don't really know. More PS2 stuff, a PS1 demo disc, and a manual for some N64 game. As well as this Toshiba Satellite Pro 430 CDT. This Acer TravelMate. What was this thing? TravelMate 340T. Sorry, I was gonna say 340T. And this Toshiba TE2100 P4 laptop. So that's a P3, by the way. If I didn't mention it, Pentium 3. So anyway, so after I come back, because my dinner is ready, I'm gonna go eat that now. But after I come back and do that. Gonna get a power cord, And we're gonna fire up this Toshiba and see what she does. So I'll be right back. Okay, so got the Satellite Pro here, and we're ready to power it up. So Mod Lem can get moved out of the way. Oh, I need to move it more actually. Big brick. Two big bricks on this table. Brick keyboard and brick laptop. Anyways, so let me hook up a PS2 mouse I have here. Where's the PS2 port? Oh, it's on that side. Alright. Maybe it's the other way. Is that even a PS2 port? Yeah, it is. It's got a keyboard and mouse symbol, so this thing the right way? Yeah, it is. Alright, so. Adapters, fucking fuck. Alright, fuck the mouse. I'm just gonna plug in the laptop. Enough fucking around. So smoke test. Oh, no smoke, but do have some lights there, so let me just make sure it's in properly. Alright, it is. And open up the computer. Whoa, didn't realize I was zoomed in. Alright, now let's do the power on self test, hopefully. Well, power's on. Yep, it looks like it works. We have 48 megabytes of RAM. Let's see what she does. Starting Windows 95. Oh, cool. Windows 95 with Microsoft Internet Explorer. Screen's a bit dim. Hopefully I can raise the brightness up. Love the sound of that old hard drive in there. That's something modern computers don't have, is audible noise from the hard drive. I mean, spindle motor noise, I can... What's it? Some scanning program. So an antivirus. See, modern computers, I could go without the spindle motor noise, but I definitely want to hear activity noise, so... Let's try and log in here. Well, trackpoint works, so it's a bit weird to use having the buttons like this, but whoa. Okay. Password is incorrect. Well, luckily this is Windows 95, so we can just nope. Alright, well, viewing angles on the screen aren't great, but you know, what do you expect, seeing as old as me? Anyways. There we are, Windows 95. I've actually never owned a machine that's run 95 before. I've used 95, but... And let's face it, if you've used Windows 98, you've basically used 95, but... Yeah, anyways. So Windows 95B, so with Internet Explorer 5.5, registered to Funtastic. That's where my uncle used to work about 10 years ago, I think. Shouldn't really say that, but yeah, anyways. So Pentium with 48 megabytes of RAM. So we don't know what Pentium exactly, but it's a good device, man. Just see what we have. All right. Have a look. So, CD-ROM. Let's see. We have a Toshiba CD-ROM drive. Let's see. Did it say what space it was? Not space. Did it say what speed it was? XM. I don't know what speed. Hard drives. Generic ID. It doesn't say. Display adapters. We have Chips and Technologies Accelerator, so not sure what that is exactly, but this mouse is a bit fidgety to use. Ah, yeah, move it so slightly, and it's, you know, Also, I'm trying to look through so if you find a floppy disk controllers. I should zoom out a bit. Sorry about that. Hard drive controllers. So standard IDE hard drive controller. Keyboard. Standard 1-in-1 keyboard. Monitor. Mouse. In-port adapter mouse. Not sure what that is. Network adapters. Apparently, it does have a network adapter. Maybe that's what that port is. Maybe that might be an Ethernet, a proprietary Ethernet thing. Dial-up adapter. Okay, it might just be a modem. All right, yeah. So I might be right with that. It might probably not Ethernet. It's probably a modem port that's on the side here. So underneath the door. So yeah. Anyways. So PCMCIA. Yep, PDC or compatible PCMCIA adapter ports. Common LPT. We have communications port, COM1, ECP printer port, generic serial port, and what's that one? Oh, it's and yeah, that's it. We just all right. Sound and video game control. What do we have for a sound card? ESS ES68 ES688 audio driver. All right, so it's an ESS card. All right, might be able to try MIDI on that. And system devices. So advanced power management support. See, plug and play bars. No, it doesn't tell me any chipset stuff. Guess I'll have to dig into system deeper to see all that. So. All right. What else do we have? It's a bit hard to use a track point with my left hand. I'm right-handed, so it'd be a bit easier. Yeah, it is a bit easier to use my right hand with this. All right. So if the camera is not angled properly, I apologize, but don't want to get my tripod out. Actually, I keep getting comments a lot saying, "Oh, why didn't you get a tripod?" And this is from videos before I actually owned a tripod. And in fact, this was a video I mentioned where I was getting one. You know, just. Honestly, just shove it up your ass. I don't want to hear about how I should be using a tripod. This is my channel. I just make the videos the way I want them to. So, yeah, let's find out how big this hard drive is. I'll tell you what, it is a bit awkward to use the mouse with these buttons. I know I mentioned that before. All right, what do we have? We have a 1.2 gigabyte hard drive. Wow. I've had drives smaller than that, but been a while since I've seen one. been a while since I've seen a drive this small, so I'll tell you what, all this mid-90s stuff, it's been a while since I've seen a lot of it. So at least about 7 years. I think last time I was working on like a Pentium system, or an 8, Pentium system, was about 2009, so, you know, let's see, we have a, looks like a version of, two versions of Office here, like some older Office 95 or 97, it looks like it's Outlook 2000. It would have to be 2000 because that's the last supported version of 95 and that's got that newer style icon. Yeah, so what do we got on here actually? I'm not going to go through any documents that are on here. Are there any documents? Yeah, apparently there are some, or maybe that's just recent documents, maybe they haven't been removed. Or maybe they have been removed, that's just the recent list. All right, let me just. So, whoops. So what's this? Indura. Not sure what that is. So. Indura Lite. Fayware client, fax stuff, I guess. Microsoft Office tools, we have the shortcut bar and Sunny, so I guess it may be at least Office 97. Microsoft Bookshelf Basics, online services, AOL Internet free trial, AT&T WorldNet, yeah, just standard Windows stuff. Startup Microsoft Office. Trend Office Scan, okay, so it's an antivirus that's on here. Windows 95, WinZip, Internet Explorer, looks like it's IE5, we had a look at it before. Looks like Microsoft Office. What version of Office is this? Let's go into Microsoft Word. Word 97. All right. And someone set it up the old way with the window in Windows. Looks like it works. Holding the camera, so I can't really type with two hands here, but there we are. Oh, and I can't even spell. Alright, well, GG. Anyways, or maybe this keyboard's fucked, so. Yeah, F. Yeah, I don't know. I'm a dick. But, yes, anyway, so, yeah, Word 97. About Microsoft Word. Registered to Funtastic. Yeah, that's, I think that is where my uncle used to work. So, yeah, he told me that he got these computers from his workplace. So that's probably why the hard drives in, the other two have been, removed. So, although I wish I didn't remove the caddies, because I actually have a spare IDE drive I can chuck in. So, anyway, and what's this version of actually, I probably shouldn't open Outlook. It's probably got some calendar stuff in there, then email stuff I don't want to show. Not much on here, though. Right. See if there's, let's see, do a MIDI test. Well, maybe not, actually. No. So, anyways, so, that has been, that is, just video of this, that is just, the video of all this stuff that I got today, or yesterday. Yeah, so a giant haul for April 20th, 2016, so, let's let this shut down here. Anyway, so, yeah, expect videos of all of this. I'm going to do a dedicated video on this Toshiba, as well as these two laptops once I get them running, once I get power adapters and hard drives for them. Maybe I might even do a video about... Maybe I might even do a retro unboxing on opening this thing up. So, I don't know. So, yeah, definitely expect some future videos about all this stuff. As well as I've even got videos, I need to do a video on that Dell sitting on the top of those two laptops there. So, got that back in January, so you might want to see that, as well as that computer right there. So, yeah, I've got some content lined up. So, out of all these three, though, this Toshiba will probably be first, because it's the only one that's actually running right now. So, definitely the most interesting out of all of them too. So, well, that and EA. So I'm actually interested in getting this thing working, like I mentioned before, because this will be a great little Windows 98 laptop to like to take around, because it's small and light, even though it doesn't have an optical drive or a floppy, still would be, you know, decent to carry around. So, anyways, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and, thank you for watching, and, see you guys next time. So, yeah.